Dear students, in the last class we solved problems on derivatives of parametric functions. Today let us continue that. Let us see some more problems on derivatives of parametric functions. Let us look at the first question. If x is equal to square root of a power sin inverse t and y is equal to square root of a to the power cos inverse t, then prove that dy by dx is equal to minus y by x. Prove that dy by dx is equal to minus y by x. Okay. So here, as we can observe, x is a function of t, y is also a function of t. We have to prove that dy by dx is equal to minus y by x. Okay. So I know for parametric differentiation, dy by dx can be written as dy by dt divided by dx by dt. For that, first I have to find out what is dx by dt. This is equal to derivative root of a power sin inverse. It looks like root x, and derivative root x is 1 by 2 root x. So derivative this is 1 by 2 root of a power sin inverse into derivative of a power sin inverse. Derivative of a power x is a power x into log a. So derivative of a power sin inverse t will be a power sin inverse t into log a into the derivative of sin inverse. What is the derivative of sin inverse t? That is 1 by root of 1 minus t square. Okay. This is dx by dt. In the same way, let us find out dy by dt. Dy by dt. Y is equal to square root of a power cos inverse t. So dy by dt will be equal to 1 by 2 into root of a power cos inverse t into the derivative of a power cos inverse t, that is a power cos inverse t into log a into the derivative of cos inverse t. Derivative of cos inverse x is minus 1 by root 1 minus x square. So derivative of cos inverse t is minus 1 by root of 1 minus t square. Okay. So we got dx by dt as well as dy by dt. Now I want dy by dx. Dy by dx is equal to dy by dt divided by dx by dt. That will give you a power sin inverse t into log a into 1 by root 1 minus t square. Okay. Here I write 2 into in the denominator 2 into root of a power sin inverse t into root of 1 minus t square. This is dy by dt. Sorry, I made a mistake. It is dx by dt. Dy by dx is given by, as you know, it is equal to dy by dt divided by dx by dt. So first you substitute dy by dt. Dy by dt is here, which is minus a power cos inverse t minus a power cos inverse t log a divided by, in the denominator, 2 into root of a power cos inverse t into root of 1 minus t square whole divided by. Now I have to write dx by dt. Dx by dt is a power sin inverse t into log a divided by 2 into root of a power sin inverse t into root of 1 minus t square. Okay, that's equal to. See, now 2 2 gets cancelled. Log a gets cancelled. Root of 1 minus t square by root 1 minus t square. That also gets cancelled. So here in the numerator we have a power cos inverse t divided by root of a power cos inverse t. That can be written as minus root of a power cos inverse divided. In the denominator here, this log a gets cancelled, root 1 minus t square gets cancelled, this 2 also gets cancelled. So we are left with a power sin inverse t divided by square root of a power sin inverse t. A power sin inverse t divided by root a power sin inverse t will give you root of a power sin inverse t. Okay. So now root of a power cos inverse t I can replace it by y, and root of a power sin inverse t
can be written as x. Okay, so we got dy by dx is equal to minus y by x. That is what we want. This is one way of solving this problem. For this problem, I will give you one more method also. Okay, see here, if I have given x is equal to root of a power sin inverse t and y is equal to root of a power cos inverse t. I'll square it. Squaring this, we get x square is equal to a power sin inverse t, and similarly square this also. Y square is equal to a power cos inverse t. Okay, x square is a power sin inverse t, y square is equal to a power cos inverse t. Now I will multiply these two equations. Multiplying these two will give you x square into y square is equal to a power sin inverse t into a power cos inverse t. So x square y square is equal to a power sin inverse t into a power cos inverse t is equal to a power sin inverse t plus cos inverse t. X square y square equal to a power sin inverse t plus cos inverse t. Sin inverse t plus cos inverse t can be written as pi by 2. Sin inverse t plus cos inverse t can be written as pi by 2. So you have x square y square is equal to a to the power pi by 2. Okay? As we know, sin inverse x plus cos inverse x equal to pi by 2. So now you differentiate this. Differentiating with respect to this, x square into derivative y square, which is 2y into dy by dx, plus y square into derivative x square, which is 2x, is equal to derivative a power pi by 2, which is equal to 0. Okay. So here what happens, 2x square y into dy by dx is equal to, taking this to RHS you will get minus 2xy square. So dy by dx is equal to, take it to RHS, minus 2xy square divided by 2x square y. 2 gets cancelled, one of those x and one of those y gets cancelled. So we will have dy by dx is equal to minus y by x, dy by dx equal to minus y by x. That is what we want. This is one more method. Now you can use either the first one or this method, which is easy. But this method, we cannot use it in every problem. Here we were able to do it only because sin inverse t plus cos inverse t is pi by 2, so that we have eliminated t in this, and we got a relation between x square and y square, between x and y, and then we got dy by dx. Okay. So wherever possible, you can eliminate that third variable or that parameter, then you can directly differentiate. Otherwise, this option you always have, that is dy by dx equal to dy by dt divided by dx by dt. Okay, let us look at the next question. If x is equal to t plus 1 by t whole power a, and y is equal to a to the power t plus 1 by t, y is equal to a to the power t plus 1 by t, then find dy by dx. Find dy by dx. Okay. So x and y both are functions of a third variable t. X and y are functions of t. We are asked to find dy by dx. So that can be obtained as dy by dt divided by dx by dt. Okay. For that, first I will find out dx by dt. That is equal to, looks like x power n. Derivative x power n is n into x power n minus 1. So derivative of this is a into t plus 1 by t whole power a minus 1 into the derivative of t plus 1 by t. What is the derivative of t? 1. What is the derivative of 1 by t? Minus 1 by t square. Okay. Dx by dt is equal to a into t plus 1 by t whole power a minus 1 into 1 minus 1 by t square. Then what is dy by dt? Dy by dt. This looks like a power x. Derivative of a power x is a power x into log a. So divided by a power t plus 1 by t is a to the power t plus 1 by t into log a into derivative of t plus 1. Derivative of t is 1. Derivative of 1 by t is minus 1 by t square. Then dy by dx, which is equal to dy by dt divided by dx by dt. That will give you a to the power t plus 1 by t into log a into 1 minus 1 by t square divided by a into t plus 1 by t whole power a minus 1 into 1 minus 1 by t square. So this 1 minus 1 by t square gets cancelled. Then you have dy by dx is equal to dy by dx is equal to a to the power t plus 1 by t into log a divided by a into t plus 1 by t whole power a minus 1. Okay? This 1 minus 1 by t square gets cancelled. Next question. If x is equal to sine cube t divided by root of cos 2t, x equal to sine cube t by root of cos 2t, and y is equal to cos cube t divided by root of cos 2t, cos 2t divided by root of cos 2t, then find dy by dx, or then prove that dy by dx is equal to minus cot 3. Dy by dx is equal to minus cot 3. X equal to sin cube t by root cos 2t and y is equal to cos cube t by root cos 2t. Then we have to prove that dy by dx is equal to minus cot 3t. Okay. So dx by dt I find out first. I have to use quotient rule here. In the denominator we will have cos 2t. In the numerator, root of cos 2t into, now the derivative of sin cube t. Derivative of sin cube t is 3 sin square t into cos 2 minus sin cube t into the derivative of cos 2t, derivative of root cos 2t, that is 1 by 2 root cos 2t into the derivative of cos 2t, which is minus sin 2t into 2. So I'll write that as minus 2 sin 2t. Okay. So let us see whether we can simplify this. Here 2 2 gets cancelled. I will take sin square t as common. Okay. I'll take sin square t as common. If I take sin square t as common, what will remain here? 3 cos t into square root of cos 2t minus into plus, no? Sin square t I have taken out, okay? So what will remain? Sin t will remain into sin 2t will remain. 2 2 we have cancelled. Divided by square root of cos 2t. Okay? This will remain. Whole divided by cos 2t. That's equal to. I will take LCM. LCM is root cos 2t. So this will become sin square t into 3 cos t cos 2t plus sin t sin 2t divided by cos 2t to the power 3 by 2. Cos 2t into root cos 2t, that will give you cos 2t to the power 3 by 2. This is dx by dt. Now let me find out dy by dt. Dy by dt, that is equal to
denominator is cos 2t. Numerator root of cos 2t into the derivative of cos 2t. Derivative of cos 2t is 3 cos square t into minus sin minus cos 2t into the derivative of root cos 2t. Derivative of root cos 2t I will write here. 1 by 2 root cos 2t into minus 2 sin 2t. That's equal. Denominator cos 2t. In the numerator I will take cos square t as common there. Okay. So if I take cos square t as common, then what will remain? Minus 3 sin t into root of cos 2t. Here minus into minus will become plus. 2 2 gets cancelled. Cos t into sin 2t divided by square root of cos 2t. So further if I simplify this, take LCM and simplify, we'll end up getting cos square t into minus 3 sin t cos 2t plus cos t sin 2t all divided by cos 2t to the power 3 by 2. Okay. Now I need dy by dx. This word is not sufficient. Let me clean this here. Okay. Dy by dx is equal to dy by dt divided by dx by dt. So when I write this divided by this, this cos 2t to the power 3 by 2 gets cancelled. So in the numerator you will have cos square t into minus 3 sin t cos 2t plus cos t sin 2t. Divided by. In the denominator, sin square t into 3 cos t cos 2t plus sin t sin 2t. Cos square t by sin square t, I will write cot square t into. Here, I will write the minus 3 sin t cos 2t as minus 2 sin t cos 2t minus sin t cos 2t and then sin 2t cos t. Sin a cos b minus cos a sin. I will write one more step. I will write like this. Minus 2 sin t cos 2t plus sin 2t cos t minus cos 2t sin. Okay. See what I did is minus 3 sin t cos 2t is there. No, I am writing as minus 2 sin t cos 2t minus sin t cos 2t and this term as it is. Denominator in the same way, in the denominator I will write 2 cos t cos 2t. 2 cos t cos 2t plus cos t cos 2t plus sin t sin 2. Okay, that's equal to cot square t into. Here look at this, sin a cos b minus cos a sin b. It will become sin a minus b. That means sin 2t minus b. That is sin t. After that I will take sin t as common. Cot square t into sin t. Then what will remain here? Here minus 2 cos 2t will remain. Minus 2 cos 2t and here 1. Okay, sin a cos b minus cos a sin b, that's equal to sin a minus b, that will give you sin 2t minus t, which is sin. That sin here will be down. Divide. Here cos a cos b plus sin a sin b, that will give you cos a minus b. So you will get cos 2t minus t, which is cos 2. So that cos t I will take common. So if I take cos t as common, then what will remain here? 2 cos 2t, 2 cos 2t plus 1. Okay, 2 cos 2t plus 1. Right.
sin t by cos t. It is tan t. Cot square t into sin t into tan t will give you cot. So if I simplify that, that will be equal to cot t, or I will write it as cos t by sin t. Cos 2 cos t into that cos 2 t is there now. I will write that as 2 cos square t minus 1 plus 1 divided by, and here sin t I will write into 2 into cos 2 t. I will write as 1 minus 2 sin square t plus 1. That's equal to cos t into, this will become minus 4 cos square t plus 2 plus 1, that is plus 3, divided by sin t into 2 plus 1 t minus 4 sin square t. That's equal to, take that cos t inside. So what do you get? 3 cos t minus 4 cos cube divided by, here I will take minus out, after that take sin t inside, minus of 4, sorry, okay, let me like this, 3 sin t minus 4 sin t. Okay. See, you know the formula, 3 sin theta minus 4 sin cube theta is equal to sin 3 theta, and 4 cos cube theta minus 3 cos theta is equal to cos cube theta. So this will become minus cos 3 t and this will become sin 3 t. So you get minus cos 3t divided by sin 3t, which is equal to minus cot 3t. Okay? Should I explain this again? So you just go back and see how I have got dx by dt and dy by dt. I think till then you have understood. After that, dy by dx is nothing but dx by dt, dy by dt divided by dx by dt. So what did I do? Cos square t into this divided by sin square t into this factor. Now cos square t by sin square t I wrote it as cot square t. Here minus 3 sin t cos 2 t is there, no? I am writing it as minus 2 sin t cos 2 t minus sin t cos 2. Just like writing minus 3 as minus 2 minus 2 in that. And this I have written as cos. Then in the denominator, 3 cos t cos 2 t we have. I am writing that as 2 cos t cos 2 t plus cos t cos 2 t. Just like writing 3 as 2 plus 1. Plus sin t sin 2 t remains as is. Then, here, look at this term. This expression. It looks like sin a cos b minus cos a sin b. Sin a cos b minus cos a sin b is equal to sin a minus b. So that will give you sin of 2t minus t. Sin of 2t minus t is sin t. So this will give you sin t. Here we have minus 2 sin t cos 2t. I took sin t as common. So if I take sin t out of this, we will have minus 2 cos 2t here and there 1 will remain. Then in the denominator, here look at this expression. This is of the form cos a cos b plus sin a sin b. Cos a cos b plus sin a sin b is equal to cos a minus b. So this will give you cos of a minus b, that means cos of 2t minus t, which is cos t. So this expression will give you cos t. Then take cos t as common. Then what will remain? 2 cos 2t plus 1. Okay. So now what did I do? I wrote cos square t as cos square t by sin square t. Cos square t by sin square t. One of those sin t got cancelled, one of those cos t got cancelled. So we have cos t by sin t, that cos t by sin t I have written. Then cos 2t, I wrote this cos 2t as 2 cos square t minus 1. And this cos 2t as 1 minus 2 sin square t. And then simplification. Okay, let us look at the next problem. Or the next set of problems. So far in differentiation, what I have seen is differentiating with respect to x, differentiating with respect to y, differentiating with respect to t, differentiating with respect to theta and all. Differentiating a given function with respect to a variable. That variable may be, if you are differentiating y with respect to x,
then that is given as dy by dx, then dy by dt, dx by dt, etc. Now we are talking about differentiating a function with respect to another function. Differentiating one function with respect to another function. That is, say, I have given you one function f of x, and I want you to differentiate it with respect to g of x. Then what? So I take one example. Take a very simple example. Let us say sin x and cos x. So if I ask you what is the derivative of sin x with respect to x, then your answer is cos x. Very simple. But now I am asking you what is the derivative of sin x with respect to cos x. So what do we have? What we can do is we can call them as say u and v. I'll take sin x as u and cos x as v. Then we want the derivative of sin x with respect to cos x, which means the derivative of u with respect to v. Derivative of u with respect to v means we need du by dv. Du by dv can be written as du by dx divided by dv by dx. Du by dv by parametric differentiation, you know, du by dv can be written as du by dx divided by dv by dx. What is du by dx? What is the derivative of sin x with respect to x? That is cos x. Then dv by dx, that is the derivative of cos x with respect to x. Derivative of cos x with respect to x is minus sin x. So this will give you minus cot x, minus cos x by sin x, which is minus cot x. Okay? Now, let us see some problems on that. Finding the derivative of one function with respect to another function. First problem. Differentiate sin cube x with respect to cos cube x. Differentiate sin cube x with respect to cos cube x. So, what do I will take this as u, that u is equal to sin cube x and v is equal to cos cube x. U is equal to sin cube x and v is equal to cos cube x. So, then du by dx. Du by dx. Derivative of sin cube x with respect to x. What is the derivative of sin cube x with respect to x? So differentiating with respect to x. We get 3 sin square x into cos x. Then dv by dx. Dv by dx is equal to derivative of cos cube x, which is 3 cos square x into minus sin x. 3 cos square x into minus sin x. We want du by dv. Du by dv is nothing but du by dx divided by dv by dx. That's equal. Du by dx is this 3 sin square x cos x. Dv by dx is minus 3 cos square x into sin x. That's equal. 3 gets cancelled. Sin x gets cancelled. Cos x gets cancelled. So we have minus tan x. Minus tan x. Okay? Next question. Differentiate e power x cube with respect to log x. Differentiate e power x cube with respect to log x. Okay. So, whatever the function we have to differentiate, you take that as u. So, that u is equal to e power x cube. So, with respect to which function, take that as v. See, it's not that you have to take like this only. You can reverse it also. You can take this as v, this as u. Then you need to find out dv by du. Okay. Now that I have taken this as u and this as v, we have to find out du by dv. Okay. So, du by dx you find out. Derivative of e power x cube is e power x cube into 3x square, which is the derivative of x cube.
then derivative log x is 1 by x. Du by dv is du by dx divided by du by dx. So this will give you 3x square into e power x cube divided by 1 by x. This x will go up, so we'll get 3x cube into e power x cube. 3x cube into e power x cube. This is the derivative of e power x cube with respect to log x. Next question. Differentiate sine inverse of 2x by 1 plus x square, 2x power plus x square, with respect to tan inverse of 2x by 1 minus x square. Differentiate sin inverse of 2x by 1 plus x square with respect to tan inverse of 2x by 1 minus x square. Okay. I call this as u. Let u is equal to sin inverse of 2x divided by 1 plus x square. And v is equal to tan inverse of 2x divided by 1 minus x square. Okay. Now I have to differentiate this with respect to x. Before I differentiate this, let us try to simplify it. I will make a substitution. Put x equal to tan theta. So when I put x equal to tan theta, this expression will be sine inverse of 2 tan theta divided by 1 plus tan square theta. Okay? 2 tan theta by 1 plus tan square theta. We very well know that 2 tan theta by 1 plus tan square theta v is sine 2 theta. So sine inverse of sine 2 theta is 2 theta. What is theta? Tan inverse x. We have made a substitution as x equal to tan theta. Therefore theta is equal to tan inverse x. Now I will make the same substitution here also. V is equal to tan inverse of 2 tan theta divided by 1 minus tan square theta. Oh, tan inverse of 2 tan theta by 1 minus tan square theta. That is nothing but tan 2. 2 tan theta divided by 1 minus tan square theta is tan 2. Tan inverse of tan 2 theta is equal to theta. 2 theta. Tan inverse of tan theta equal to theta. Now tan inverse of tan 2 theta, that's equal to 2 theta. What is theta? We have taken x equal to tan theta. So theta is equal to tan inverse x. So we get d is equal to 2 tan inverse x. U is 2 tan inverse x. V is also 2 tan inverse x. So obviously du by dx is equal to 1. It's as good as differentiating x with respect to x. Okay. So if you want more clarification, you can see this. If we want du by dv, right? Du by dv is nothing but du by dx divided by dv by dx. du by dx. U is equal to 2 tan inverse x. Derivative of 2 tan inverse x is 2 into 1 by 1 plus x square. In other words, 2 by 1 plus x square. Similarly, derivative of v. V is 2 tan inverse x. Whose derivative is 2 divided by 1 plus x square. So that gets cancelled. Hence, you have du by dv is equal to 1. Let us look at the next question. Differentiate tan inverse of 1 plus x square minus 1 by x, tan inverse root of 1 plus x square minus 1 by x, with respect to cos inverse of 1 minus x square divided by 1 plus x square. You want to differentiate tan inverse root of 1 plus x square minus 1 by x with respect to cos inverse of 1 minus x square by 1 plus x square. I take this as u. Let u is equal to tan inverse of
root of 1 plus x square minus 1 divided by x.
First we shall simplify this, and I will take this as b as always.
B is equal to cos inverse of 1 minus x square by 1 plus x square.
See, it's not that you have to take u and v only, you can take whatever you want. You take them as two variables and differentiate this with respect to x, differentiate this with respect to x. Then to find the derivative of this function with respect to that function. So derivative of this divided by the derivative of this. So before we differentiate, let us first simplify this. I'll make a substitution, put x equal to tan. See, because as soon as I say root of 1 plus x square, immediately I do go for the substitution. X equal to tan. That will imply that theta is equal to tan inverse x. Then u is equal to tan inverse of root of 1 plus tan square theta minus 1 divided by tan. 1 plus tan square theta is, as we know, which is secant square theta, root of that is secant theta, minus 1 divided by tan. Root of secant theta minus 1 by tan. Secant theta can be written as 1 by cos theta minus 1 divided by, I'll write tan theta as sin theta by cos theta. Okay? Take LCM here, this will become 1 minus cos theta by cos theta. Denominator is sin theta by cos theta. That cos theta gets cancelled. So we have tan inverse of 1 minus cos theta divided by sin. Now I will write the 1 minus cos theta as 2 sin square theta by 2. Divided by sin theta as 2 sin theta by 2 cos theta. So sin theta by 2 gets cancelled. You are left with sin theta by 2 by cos theta by 2, which can be written as tan theta. Tan inverse of tan theta by 2 is equal to theta by 2. So u is equal to 1 by 2 into tan inverse x. We have taken x equal to tan theta, therefore theta equal to tan inverse x. Then on the other hand, we have v. V is equal to cos inverse of 1 minus x square divided by 1 plus x square. This cos inverse of 1 minus x square by 1 plus x square, we already know that it is nothing but 2 tan inverse x. This is a well-known formula which you have already learned during our previous chapter, inverse trigonometric function. I think you should know. If you don't know, also not a problem. You put x equal to tan theta. If I put x equal to tan theta, you get 1 minus tan square theta by 1 plus tan square theta. 1 minus tan square theta by 1 plus tan square theta is equal to cos 2 theta. Then cos inverse of cos 2 theta is equal to 2 theta. We have made a substitution as x equal to tan theta, therefore theta will become tan inverse x. So this expression will become 2 tan inverse x. Right? So, u is equal to 1 by 2 tan inverse x and v is equal to 2 tan inverse x. We want du by dv. Du by dv is nothing but du by dx divided by dv by dx. Du by dx, the derivative u with respect to x is 1 by 2 into derivative 1 by tan inverse x is 1 by 1 plus x square. Divide. Here I want the derivative of v with respect to x, that is 2 into 1 by 1 plus x square. This 1 by 1 plus x square gets cancelled. 1 by 2 by 2 will become 1 by 4. Okay? That's it. With that, I will stop for this class. We shall continue in the next class. In the next class, we will discuss the second order derivatives.